there's so much content to compete with. To break through the clutter, you have to keep coming up with fresh ideas. Whether you're a business owner or a seasoned marketing professional, knowing what to write isn't always an easy thing. Where do I start? What do I write next? These questions can feel overwhelming when you have tight deadlines and a blank page. But guess what? Writer's block is dead. I'm sure you've heard about generative AI. It's everywhere. When used right, it can be a powerful tool to get you from that blank page to your first draft. But I'm sure you're still trying to figure out how exactly you can use it in your marketing. If you stick with me to the end of this video, you will have a few prompts you can use right away to get started on your next email. Hey, I'm Justin. I'm a video producer here at Mailchimp, and I make a lot of content. And just like you, I'm constantly staring at a blank page wondering, what do we say this time? You don't have to do that anymore. Just pull up your favorite generative AI platform and tell it what you need. If you're new to the topic, generative AI, or Gen AI for short, produces copy, images, and even video based on your prompts. These prompts could be questions, descriptions, whatever you need. Working with Gen AI can feel a lot like working with your favorite, highly motivated intern. When people think of Gen AI, they picture tools like ChatGPT and DALL-E, but there are a bunch of them out there, and the list continues to grow. It is exciting that Gen AI can produce content within seconds, but I want to be real with you. Gen AI is not meant to replace human creativity or expertise. It's not always going to return flawless results, and it can't read your mind. It's simply a tool to help you create content and generate ideas more efficiently. We think one of the most powerful ways to use Gen AI right now is for inspiration. For example, if you have no idea what to write for your email subject line, and even if you don't know what to ask Gen AI, don't feel discouraged. It's okay to start broad. When you're ready to write your prompt, enter a little about your goal and your brand. I'll give you an example with the Potted Planner. It's our fictional plant company we use here at Mailchimp when we're teaching. I write something like, give me 5 playful subject lines to promote a rose sale at my friendly neighborhood plant care store. Cool, that should give you some ideas to work with. After you review that first output, you can get more specific with your prompts to get even closer to what you're looking for. You can enter more details about the sale, like make the promotion 15% off, or ask it questions like, what's a good subject line to engage an audience of experienced gardeners? This kind of works like a conversation. Gen AI remembers the context of your previous prompt in the chat, so you don't have to repeat yourself or start from scratch, but it's a good idea to give it feedback, such as keep the part that says this, but change the part that says that. The main thing is just to be as clear as you can about your objective so you get better results. Once you have an output that looks pretty good, you might find that something still doesn't quite feel like you or sound like your brand. Gen AI can help you speed through revisions. You can enter prompts like, make the paragraph more persuasive. Write the sentence in active voice, or change the intro to sound more casual. Gen AI has the ability to understand and process your adjectives to return more tailored results. Again, just be as descriptive as possible. You can use Gen AI and Mailchimp to streamline your revisions as well. We have quick actions like shorten and change tone too. Whatever approach you take with your prompts, don't be afraid to experiment. These days, customers expect content to be tailored to their needs and interests. To provide a personalized experience, you might need multiple versions of an email. For instance, you may have customers in different cities, so you could prompt your Gen AI tool to rewrite this to welcome new customers in Atlanta, just to make it more personalized to them. Multiple variations can also help you find out what type of messaging resonates with your audience. Let's say you have a newsletter and your headlines are usually pretty straightforward. You could use Gen AI to create a witty headline, or one that's a bit more persuasive, and then run an A/B test to see how it performs compared to one of your more standard headlines. But before you send anything out to your customers, make sure you give your email a human touch. Really make the content your own. Remember to check all claims and statistics. Like your favorite intern, Gen AI isn't perfect. Treat the content Gen AI provides to you as a draft that still needs some editing. And I strongly recommend that you keep track of your prompts that work well for you so you can just reuse them in the future. At the end of the day, the possibilities are endless with generative AI. It can help you create higher quality content in less time so you can focus on other areas of your business. That said, beyond the examples I mentioned already, here are a few prompt templates that I think any email marketer could use to get started with Gen AI right away. Feel free to pause here or come back to this video to try these out. And don't forget to revise and keep prompting to make the output specific to your needs. We want to hear how you've been using Gen AI for your business and your marketing. Let us know in the comments. And if you've enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to our channel for more. Thank you.